Welcome to the Borderless Ministry of Thrive in Christ. I'm Kenneth. It's so good to talk to you again. Now, this is what the Lord says for now. Comfort one another as you keep looking to me and fix your eyes on me, because I will never leave you nor forsake my people, no matter what has become of this world. My promises for my people is not slack, and I am in the midst of preparing my bride for my glorious coming. There shall be a great ingathering and reunion of my people for those who have fallen asleep together with those who are alive. Hallelujah! The Lord says there will be a great ingathering and reunion of His people, whether those who have fallen asleep, who is no more on earth, or those who are still alive, together. See the word there, together. So God wants me to emphasize this word, together. I underline the word, together. So will you meet your loved ones or good friends again up there in heaven? Yes, for all of us who are in Christ, yes. There will be a reunion for all of us. And so I'm going to expound on all that God has spoken today from the Bible verses. Now, I also will show you where the word rapture is in the Bible. I begin first with 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13 to 14. Apostle Paul wrote this, "But I do not want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who have fallen asleep, lest you sorrow as others who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who sleep in Jesus." See, sleep in Jesus. It's not just sleep, but sleep in Jesus, in Christ. Now, by the way, the word asleep here is koimao in Greek. It can mean to fall asleep. Now, in the context of our study today here, it means to cease from this earth, or in other words, deceased. So fall asleep here means a person has been brought home into the arms of the Lord. Now I continue with 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 15 to 16. "For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord will by no means precede those who are asleep." So in the context of asleep here means those who are deceased, no more on this earth. I continue, "For the Lord himself will descend from heaven," hallelujah, "with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God," with the shofar of God, "and the dead in Christ will rise first." It means those who are asleep, they will rise first. And I continue, 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 17 to 18, "Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words." Now, I want you to notice the word together here. Now, say with me the word together. Together. Now, if you look at the verses here, "Then we who are alive and remain on this earth shall be caught up together with them." Who are these them here? Those who have fallen asleep. It means we are going to be together with those who have fallen asleep to meet the Lord in the air. And thus, we shall always be with the Lord. Now, I read from the Amplified Bible. It makes it so much more clearer here. 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 17 to 18, Amplified Bible. "Then we who are alive and remain on this earth, on the earth, will simultaneously be caught up, raptured, together with them." Who are these them here? The resurrected ones. Those who have fallen asleep, who have been raised. "In the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will always be with the Lord." Therefore, comfort and encourage one another with these words concerning our reunion with believers who have died. See the word reunion here? Reunion with believers who have fallen asleep, who have gone before us. Now, beloved of God, do you see that? Reunion, ingathering from the Lord for all those who have fallen asleep, who have gone before us, and those who are remain. There will be a reunion. It means for those of you who have lost your loved ones or good friends who are in Christ, you are going to have a reunion with them, meeting the Lord together. Hallelujah. Now, the word together here is hama in Greek. It means at the same time. Now, that's what James Strong, in his Strong's Concordance, defined it as. At the same time. It means you at the same time together with those who have gone before us, who have left this earth, who have deceased, who have fallen asleep. You will be meeting the Lord together. Another definition of hama is closeness in being together. It means you will see and meet each other together, even as you meet the Lord in the air up there. So as you allow the Lord to continue to wash you and cleanse you, you are the bride of Christ, awaiting for the coming of the bridegroom, that's Jesus. Yes, allow God to continue to wash you clean so that you will be unblemished, blameless, pure before the Lord, ready for the coming of Jesus, the bridegroom. Now, I'm going to show you here these words caught up that you saw just now in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 17. What is this caught up here? Now, in the Amplified Bible, there's a bracket that says that is rapture. Now, the word caught up here is harpazo in Greek. It can mean being pulled away, being seized away, being caught away, being taken away. Now, in the context of being caught up here, in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 17, it means you are being pulled away by the Lord. You are being seized away, caught away, taken away by the Lord from this earth to meet Him face to face, to be in His presence, in His glory, to be in His arms, the Heavenly Father's arms. Now, here is where the word rapture comes from. That's how the word rapture in your English is derived from. Now, from this word caught up. Now, the word caught up here is raptura in medieval Latin. Now, what is this medieval age? Medieval age is a period between Roman Empire and the Renaissance in Europe. And that's between the 5th century and towards the end of 15th century. Now, the word raptura in medieval Latin here, which later on the French call it rapture, and that's how the English word rapture comes from as well, is an act of carrying away, carrying off, seizing away. So the word raptura in medieval Latin is equivalent to the word harpazo in Greek here. Both speaks of being carried away by the Lord. It means the Lord carry you away from this earth. The Lord seized you away from the earth. The Lord carrying you off from this earth to meet Him in the air. So from our Bible study today, there will be an ingathering between those who have been deceased and those who are still alive together. Say the word one more time. Together. It means you'll be meeting each other as you meet the Lord in the air. And that is good news for us, especially for many of you. You may have lost a loved one before. You may have lost a good friend before and they have passed on. But if they are in Christ, you are going to meet them together. As I have taught you today, that is an assurance and comfort that the Lord wants you to receive today. And that's why the Apostle Paul wrote in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 18, therefore comfort one another. Now, you know what this means? It means those in Christ who have departed from this earth, your loved ones, your good friends, they are just merely sleeping. They are actually not dead. That's why Apostle Paul wrote there, asleep here. Now, the Bible says so. This is not a fantasy. This is not a make-believe. This is the reality in the spiritual realm. Those who are in Christ, who have received Jesus Christ as their personal Savior and Lord, when their spirit depart from their body, they are not dead. They are just asleep. And you know what this means? You will be meeting those loved ones and good friends of yours who have departed from the earth one day. Now, let me explain the word asleep here in the context of what Apostle Paul wrote here in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. Now, we have a glimpse of eternity, actually, while we are on earth. Now, imagine the whole day you have been running everywhere, you have been so busy, and by the end of the day, you are so tired. And say you sleep at 10 p.m. Now, you're so exhausted, so tired, and the moment you lie down on the bed, you fall asleep. And the next thing you know is because you're so tired, your body's so tired, your spirit and soul as well. And the next thing you realize is you wake up and it's already 6 a.m. From 10 p.m. to 6 a.m., 8 hours passed by just like that. Now, it's like when you sleep and then you wake up and 8 hours just passed by, just like that. Have you experienced that before? Now, you have experienced the glimpse of what it is like in eternity. Now, in the spiritual realm, in eternity, we are not time-bound anymore. Just a twinkling of an eye, and just like that, 8 hours. Just like when you fall asleep while you are on this earth. Now, it is the same with those of your loved ones or your good friends who have departed. They are now fallen asleep in Christ. Now, the moment they wake up and you are going to meet them, and because there's no time bound anymore, there's no time limit anymore, and that is what eternity means. So, sleeping physically while we are on earth is actually a glimpse of what it is like in eternity. Now, in contrast to 8 hours, imagine 8 hours in your waking life, in your waking time. And imagine you have to wait for the plane or the bus or the train for 8 hours. It is excruciatingly hard and difficult. Even 1 hour of waiting seems to be so long. What more? 8 hours. But when you fall asleep, 8 hours just pass by just like that, especially when it was a tiring day. Therefore, beloved of God, be comforted if your loved ones or your good friends have gone home to be with the Lord. You know, recently, even for me, a good friend and a fellow minister of God of mine has gone home to be with the Lord. God brought him home after he has fulfilled God's purposes on this earth. Now, surely I will miss him, but I can be comforted because it's actually not a permanent loss. Because as the scripture says just now, together you are going to meet all your loved ones, all your good friends, those whom you miss. You are going to be reunited in gathering by the Lord, to meet the Lord together. Now, isn't that a deep assurance for all of us who are in Christ? Isn't that a deep comfort for all of us who are in Christ? Yes, you may have missed some of your loved ones who have departed from this earth, your good friends who may have departed from this earth, but that is just temporary. But you are going to meet them together again. There will be a reunion before the Lord. Amen? Now, this is not my idea. Check it out, the Bible yourself, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 here. The Bible says so. That is why, beloved of God, it is so, so urgent and important to share about Jesus to your loved ones, to those whom you care, to those whom you love. You want to see them in eternity together. Now, this is the time. This is the season. Share the love of Jesus. Pray for them. Pray for their spiritual eyes to be open so that they will see that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father, Heavenly Father, except through Jesus. So this is a very important time to preach the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ, wherever they may be. It doesn't even have to be physically. Nowadays, you can share through social media. You can Zoom with them. You can WhatsApp video call with them. In whichever way, just bring out the good news of Jesus Christ. Let them see that Jesus is the Lord. Only Jesus, Yeshua, the salvation, can save them from this fallen world. And that's how we all can be together. So this is the time. Pray for your loved ones. Pray for your good friends so that we can be together. And for those who are already in Christ, we can comfort one another. Yes, there may be some who may have departed earlier than us, but we will all be having a reunion together. So this is something that God wants to encourage all of us today. After all, the earth is only a temporary place. You know it very well. We are just sojourners. We are just pilgrims or quote-unquote aliens. The Bible says so. Our permanent place is up there where you will see no more pain or suffering. And we will all be in the loving arms and embrace of the Lord. Indeed, once any one of us, we have fulfilled our God-given purposes on this earth, He will bring us home. There will be a homecoming. Surely, each of us, we have lost a loved one or a good friend before. Now, they may have left us first and gone home to be with the Lord first, but we shall meet them together. The word for today is, remember, together. Now, for some of you who have lost your loved ones or good friends before, these are God's words of comfort for you. According to 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 13 to 18. Now, this is an assurance for all of us. So, beloved of God, take heart, be encouraged, stay strong. No matter what happens in this world, keep running this race of faith. Keep running this race of faith. Keep fulfilling all that God has purposed for you to be on this earth. Keep focusing on the Lord. Keep fixing your eyes on the Lord. Keep trusting the Lord just as the Lord has spoken today. And once you have finished all that you need to do on this earth, all that God has destined for you, all that God has purposed for you, yes, we will be taken up. And that is supposed to be a time of celebration. And that is why Jesus says in John 14, verse 1 to 4, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself." See the words I underlined here. I will come again and receive you to myself. So that ties up to 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13 to 18 just now. I continue, "That where I am, you may be also. And where I go, you know. And the way, you know." So over here, Jesus was talking to his disciples who know him and are known by the Lord. I continue with John 14, verse 5 to 7. Thomas, one of his disciples, said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" And Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you had known me, you would have known my Father also. And from now on, you know him and have seen him." It means Jesus was saying to his disciple, if you see me, you would have seen my Father as well, because Jesus and the Father are one. You see, God the Father was being revealed through Jesus who came. And that's what Jesus was telling Thomas. And that's why it is so, so important to preach Christ to your loved ones, to those whom you care especially, even to strangers, even those whom you just have known, even those whom you just got to know, because you wouldn't want them to be lost permanently. You want to be together, not just on this earth, but in eternity, the permanent place. Today's message is very basic actually, but it is so important. It is so important for us to comfort one another in this, to be assured of all that God has spoken today in the Word of God. Amen. Let us pray. We thank you, Lord God, that you have reminded us of all these verses, that we will be together with those who have fallen asleep to meet you in the air, according to 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 13 to 18. Therefore, we receive your assurance. We receive your comfort as we keep looking to you and fix our eyes on you till the day of your glorious coming. We thank you, Lord God, that today you have shown us that there will be a great ingathering and reunion of your beloved for those who have fallen asleep together with those who are alive and remain. All this we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. So there you have it. Today's message is a message of comfort for you to keep running the race of faith and keep fulfilling all that God has purposed for you on this earth. And encourage one another, comfort one another, and continue to share about Jesus, about the love of Jesus. When everything else on this earth fails, the Lord's love, Jesus' love, never fails. So therefore, God bless you and have a wonderful day.